Let's talk about Honeycomb actionable SLOs and how they can help you. Here we're looking at a real production SLO, latency per event. This is an SLO that computes the time it takes Honeycomb to process every single event ingested into our platform. In large batches, we're allowed 5 milliseconds per individual event inside that batch, as defined by this SLI here, which looks at a couple different various rules as well. And we're holding ourselves to a 4-9 goal over 30 days. Here we're holding just below 35%, kind of holding steady. Now to help us be on top of our SLO, we've got exhaustion time alerts, and we have two of them configured here. We go ahead and configure these alerts. I've got my first one, 24 hours, is going to Slack. My 4-hour one here goes to pager duty. These alerts allow me to be only notified when something's really happening by pager duty, and if it's a slow burn, we can put that in Slack and get to it when we have time. Now, our SLO itself also has a heat map and allows us to investigate and take action when things happen. Let's go look at a time period where something actually did happen right here in this little downslope. That was about 3 days ago. And I can get there by hitting these arrow buttons here. So I'll hit this arrow button 3 times to go back to 3 days. Honeycomb will go back in time. You can see with the shaded indicator right here where we're selected over our drop. And my heat map, it's got this yellow or gold colored part of it. These are the things that have erred, that have violated my SLI's definition. All the other ones, these are the successful items, these successful events that we like. Now what Honeycomb does is almost magical. It'll take every single attribute for every single event that erred and compare them versus everything else to tell you why it's happening. And down here, I've got these results below for me. I can see which IP address they come from. I know which team is responsible for these, and I can hover over this team ID, and it's 62% of all my errors were coming from the exact same team or tenant or customer in Honeycomb's parlance. This is big. I could take action on this right here. And what's great about this is I did not design or define which attributes to include. This is my dashboard, my observability dashboard based on an SLO, where the charts change based on the data itself, and I don't have to predefine that drill path. I could come here and say, let's filter on this user and continue that investigation from here. When the heat map comes up, it's pretty clear when the issue is happening. And we go ahead and drill down on any of these items, discover more, and understand exactly what was happening and why this issue was happening and what we could do to fix it. All with the power of SLOs and a couple mouse clicks.